Happy Monday, folks. Happy Easter Monday. It's not Easter Monday. That's next Monday. Oh boy, I'm really getting ahead of myself. You know what threw me off is I had the weekend off. The only thing I had to do was host Church Live, but it's Easter Monday next Monday. Happy Back to School Day, which is, you know, kids, that's pretty good because they just had 2 weeks off. And then this coming weekend, you get Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday off. And I'm sure the teachers are going to be grateful for only having to do 4 days too. But hey, welcome back from spring break. And be encouraged. God is good. He knows what he's doing. It was really good to get away with my wife this weekend for a little trip. And we didn't really do much because you're supposed to stay safe. So we did, and but we're grateful for the chance to kind of air our brains out and change the scenery. I'm glad I've got my buddy Aiden here. He came and watched my dogs so I could get away. Anyway, so it kind of felt like it was a long weekend for me, but we know that it wasn't because now we're awake. So would you pray with me? Father, obviously I need your help today. We all do right now, Lord. Father, we anticipate better days ahead to be able to gather with your people, to be able to have the normal freedoms of life, to come and go, to hug people, to hang out with them, to play games with them, to watch movies with them, to sing with them at church. We long for this, Lord. We really do. We pray you grant us patience and endurance while we wait. We trust you, Lord. We pray that we would trust you more. Even have little details like timing down, we know that you've got that. So, Lord, we trust you. We ask you for your patience. Jesus, you waited 30 years to start your ministry. So we ask you for that resolve, knowing that in the waiting, you're building us up, getting us ready for what you have for us. The next chapter in the church, Lord, where there's going to be so many new faces at church and so many new members of a force that changes the world for your sake. And Jesus, I pray you bless these folks watching, and me too, Jesus, with your strength and wisdom from your holy word, in your mighty name, Jesus, our living God. Amen. Well, guys, we're in Psalm 108 today, and it is not a long one. It's 13 verses, but it's packed with some good stuff. And I would just encourage you to follow along. If you have your Bible, turn it into the New Living Translation if it's on your phone. If it's not on your phone, that's okay. If it's on a real Bible, even better. I mean, the real Bible is in your phone anyway. Okay, you guys are putting up with the tired guy today. It's okay. My heart, this is a good thing to be able to say, my heart is confident in you, oh God. It's possible to have humble confidence. There's a lot of people that are confident and they're cocky. They're confident in their degree. They're confident in their experience. They're confident in their bank account. They're confident in their physical might and their prowess. They're confident in their fame. People are confident in their black belt. They're confident in what they've done, and they like to tell you about their resume. I myself am guilty of this. We've got to watch that, because our confidence can be real if it's in God. But to get that, you got to be humble, right? Realize that he is the only one that's good. He gives me his goodness. He changes my character. And in him, I can be confident. So this is what the psalmist is saying. My heart is confident in you, Lord. No wonder I can sing your praises with all my heart. Not my praises, his praises, right? I sing praises to him, because I'm confident in him. He's the one that's got the strength to get me through, to get me through this day, to accomplish the impossible. So, wake up, lyre and harp. Diddle-ding. My guitar's at the hub, I'll still play it. I will wake the dawn with my song. So this morning, I woke up, and with just my voice, I sang to God. This is also why instruments are so good. I'm looking forward to the drive-in church this Sunday to have the drums for the first time in a year. And the guitar and the keys and the bass and the singers to sing praises loudly, to make us a joyful noise to the Lord. So to assist us in glorifying God, he gave us instruments. What is your favorite instrument? In an orchestra? I can't think of anything better than those French horns cutting in there and singing a mighty song with the brass and the strings and all of the timpani. Boom, 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 boom. To assist us in making a joyful noise, the Lord has allowed us to invent instruments. If you go back to Genesis, you can read in the first four chapters, the first guy to invent instruments in music. And he says, with those instruments, this is what you should do. I want to thank the Lord. I want to thank you, Lord, among all the people. I will sing praises among your nations. One of the reasons I love doing church outside is anybody that's in the vicinity hears the joyful noise. It's not that we want to be obnoxious or loud for the sake of being loud, but I love it when I walk in Askew's and people said, I heard your music this morning. It was cool. And they feel God's presence through the song, right? I want you to think about this, Kay. Ask God for the right timing and the right opportunity for you to mention him. He says, I will thank you, Lord, among all the people. So when you get a chance to thank God for something he's done, you know, just, oh man, we're blessed. Look at this weather, you know? Make sure the timing's right. Don't be cheesy. Don't be a cheesy Christian. But ask God for the right chance to thank him for his goodness, right? And I got to tell you, I'm so thankful for my mom. She turned 75 yesterday. I'm thankful for my 21-year-old daughter, Bethany, and the miracle of her life. I'm thankful. And I want to tell the world that God is good. So mention God when you can in the right way to his glory. Remember, you're confident in him, not in you, right? For his unfailing love is higher than the heavens. What does that mean? You look up, go outside and look up. Look how big the sky is. God's love for you is bigger than the sky. Your faithfulness, Lord, reaches to the clouds. Be exalted, O God, above the highest heavens. May God be lifted up. May his glory shine over all the earth. God's exaltation, his glory, when you worship him, when you sing he's good, when you say he's good, when you show people he's good by how you live, concentrating on him is your source of happiness. You're probably talking too much about you and your problems and not enough about God. You're probably talking about the problems of the world too much and not enough about God and what he's done and what he's doing. Concentrate on him. That's the source of your happiness. He is the source of eternal joy. So we need to talk more about him. We need to think more about him. The Bible says that he will keep us in perfect peace if our mind is stayed on him, if we're concentrating on him. God has promised this by his holiness. What has he promised? His salvation. As sure as God is holy, the salvation he sent is coming. It has come in Jesus, right? He says, I will take the land and divide it up. I'll divide Shechem with joy. I'll measure out the valley of Succoth. Gilead is mine. Manasseh too. People from all over. Ephraim is my armor and my helmet and my sword. Judah is my scepter. I will produce my kings through normal people. God will take normal people. Reach out to them. Parcel off where they're supposed to be. Put them in the right spot to glorify him. And we can compliment God. What does a scepter do to a king? It compliments God and his majesty. God has chosen to adorn himself with his people, the beauty of his work. It enhances his majesty when you see 1,000 people from all over the world, from all different countries, the cosmopolitan church gathered to worship God. You can see the beauty of God's majesty through that. Verse 9 says the bad guys are going down. Moab, those bad guys, the Moabites, they're my wash basin. They'll become my servant. I will wipe my feet on Edom. The Edomites were evil people. God's going to conquer them. I will shout in triumph over Philistia. That's where Goliath came from. The villains are going down. God's going to take them down. But then he's going to redeem some of them. We went over a psalm a few weeks ago where God said, Philistia will be my servants. Egypt will be my servants. Those were enemies of God. God's going to turn even his enemies into the church, into his friends. Who will bring me into the fortified city? Who will bring us victory over Edom? Lord, please don't reject us. Have you rejected us, O God? Will you no longer march with your armies? Remember, our confidence is in him. So the psalmist is saying, Lord, I need to know that you're with me, because we can't do it without you. This is where humble confidence comes from, is saying, Lord, I can't do this alone. That's the faith, saying, I can't do this day alone. Lord, please help us against our enemies. This is the line that was key for me this morning. Help us against our enemies, Lord, because all human help is useless on its own. We've made excellent progress today if, in this session, class, we get this point. We know that all human help is useless if God is not in it. God will go recruit some humans to do his good work. But humans alone have proven time and again they can't do it on their own. We can't do it on our own. All human help is useless if God is not in it. That's why this morning, on a Monday especially, we appeal to God for his leadership in our lives, his solutions, his wisdom, and his street smarts. With God's help, verse 13 says, we will do mighty things. So put those together. All human help is useless. With God's help, we can do mighty things. Our confidence is in him, not us. So think about that again. All human help is useless, but with God's help, we can do mighty things. Keep that as your concentration day. Meditate upon it. All human help is useless, but with God's help, you and I can change the world. We really can. And how does the world change? One person at a time. Save one. Go after one person today. And how did Jesus do this? We know Jesus trampled down the foe of death. You can have confidence because you've got a Savior who conquered death. He conquered sin and death. He is great. He is with you today, step by step. And because of him, because Christ is risen from the dead, you and I can have confidence. Because if Jesus could beat death, he can help you and me with this day ahead. Listen to Matt Maher sing this great song.
Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you, and I will seek you in the morning, and I will learn to walk in your ways, and step by step you lead me, and I will follow you.
Just sing that together this morning and just open our hearts, our minds to this great reality called eternity, the presence of God that's with us, that's for us, not against us this morning. We just ask the Holy Spirit come and help us to pray. Fix morning, the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the grave is available to you. It's living and active and working in your life this morning. It's bringing dead parts to life. It's bringing sleepy parts awake. It's waking up your heart this morning. It's not based on your strength. It's not based on what you've done. It's based solely on the amazing, all-sufficient work of the cross and the love of God poured out through it. So let's make ourselves available to that grace this morning. Amen. Let's cooperate with it. Say yes to it in our hearts and our lives. Let it move and stir us this morning. Stir us to worship. We see you. Death, where is your sting? Oh, hell, where is your victory? Oh, church, come stand in the light. The glory of God has defeated the night. Sing it, oh, death, where is your sting?
Love that song. Get it on your playlist. I made an Easter playlist yesterday. Put that one at the top. Christ is Risen by Matt Maher. Get it in your soul. Sandra has had that song for her alarm clock in the morning for 5 years. Every morning I hear the doon, 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 the notes, and then I get in my head, Christ is risen from the dead. We are one in him again. Get in your head. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Hey, love you guys. Let's pray. Lord, with your help, we know we can do mighty things. So, Lord, help us to rely on your help. Humble us, make us confident in you alone. Jesus, you've risen from the grave. Your spirit that raised Jesus from the grave, Father, the Holy Spirit is in us. And I pray that you raise us up today. With your help, we can do mighty things. We worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus is with you. He loves you. Go have a good Monday morning. And hey, watch The Chosen this week. It's Easter. Watch all 8 episodes of The Chosen because Easter Sunday is season 2 at 5 p.m. on YouTube. Love you.